Most people live with a certain amount of stress, but a recent national study shows the problem's been getting worse. Joining us with some advice on getting that stress under control is the founder of Redcross Concierge Personalized Medicine, Dr. Ken Redcross. Thank you very much for being with us.
Thank you, Chris. I'm happy to be here once again.
Start with the trend. What's been going on here?
Yeah, we've had the most increase in spike of our stress than we had in the past 10 years. The American Psychological Association actually tracks this sort of thing. Some of the stress we're seeing is due to the election. It doesn't really matter what side of the aisle you're on. The point is, it is change, and it's very hard when we're dealing with that. But the big thing to really keep in mind, Chris, is there are some things that we can do to really create what I like to call a stress reduction makeover that we can do within 15 minutes of our day, because I know we're all so busy.
Before we get into the makeover, one other thing is good to remind people of here is that, you know, stress isn't that you just get worked up and then you relax. Stress can cause more serious problems,
yeah,
too.
Yeah, stress can cause some important problems. Number one, it can decrease or affect our immune system. The second thing, it can actually cause disease, and we're talking about chronic stress here. Now, there is only one kind of stress that's okay, and that's the one that allows us to kind of come up and perform for our jobs and that sort of thing. But when it becomes chronic, it can become a huge, huge problem,
Chris. What does that mean when stress is chronic?
So when stress is chronic, it's something that you really don't get an opportunity to unplug throughout the day. In other words, you're always at this heightened state. And when that sort of thing happens, we start increasing our risk for cardiac disease and also for depression as well. These are big things that we see around stress that we all have to be able to talk openly about.
Well, let's say somebody says, I have stress because I have a stressful job. I work 8 hours a day. It's pretty much nonstop, that kind of a thing. So what could you do about that?
Well, some of the things we'll do, we'll talk about them or we'll touch on some of those things today that you can do. But the other thing is you have to be willing to kind of reassess where you are in your life. And that's important as we, like I said, touch on some of these things today.
Well, one of the things, certainly, and I'm already looking at what you've got in front of you here, it has to do with diet. So how does diet make a difference?
You know why, Chris? Because I always say that food is medicine. And when we think about it that way, we're very cognizant about what we put into our bodies. Now, one of the first things I love to talk about is that, and we talked off air about the importance of yogurt. And you were wondering, how can this be helpful and beneficial? Well, yogurt has probiotics. And probiotics are very important to help support our immune health. Because don't forget, when we're talking about stress, it can affect our immunity. So that's why I say, luckily you're already on board, but I hope a lot of the viewers also understand the importance of something like yogurt that we can start with in the morning. The other thing that you and I kind of chatted about was that of the mushrooms. And it's funny whenever I talk about that because everyone says, what does that have to do with anything? Well, mushrooms actually are so important because they help to increase your white blood cell count. And they also make your white blood cells more aggressive as well, which is something that you really want when your immunity is waning. And so it's important. Maybe consider something like a mushroom omelet or something like that each and every morning. But if it's difficult, you can also consider some supplementation such as AHCC. See, AHCC has a precise mix of medicinal mushrooms that was shown in human clinical trials to not only support your immune system, but it was also shown to have anti-cancer properties as well. And for that reason, AHCC is the number one immune supplement in Japan. So the key there when we talk about some of these things is trying to stay closer to the earth. Other thing here, oats and barley.
Oats and barley
have a fiber, and this fiber is called beta-glucan, and the key here is that it's been shown to have antimicrobial benefits and also antioxidant benefits as well. So we're already talking about all of these, which I love to call breakfast boosters, to help us deal with our stress in the morning before we even get on the road.
Now, what about what kind of oats? Because the first thing I think of is Quaker oats, but they're not really, you know, pure, you know, unadulterated.
Right.
So, I mean, do they have to be that pure to make a difference?
You know, that's an absolutely wonderful question because they actually don't. Because these in particular are steel-cut oats. I like that sort of thing because I'm a holistic guy, so I like to get steel-cut oats. But actually, they found out that it was just the oats themselves that were actually beneficial for what we're talking about, at least.
Well, also, you're going to break the kind of routine that's associated with chronic stress. I see here a couple of, furnishings, maybe? Explain how these can help us overcome.
These aren't furnishings, Chris. These are to allow us to breathe deeper daily. And by that, I'm saying right here, I talked about my mat earlier because this is the meditation mat. And the key here is that with meditation, which is controlled breathing, it allows us to really focus on those things such as self-awareness. What's really going on in our lives? This job that is 8 or 12 hours a day, is that the job I really should be doing? Is that bringing me happiness or is that bringing me illness? And those are the things you need to think about. The other thing I brought here is the Fitbit. And the reason why is because something else that I find very beneficial is high intensity interval training. I am a CrossFitter, so that's the way I deal and manage with my stress. The other thing I have here too, Chris, is actually a yoga mat. And we all are understanding the importance of yoga now, because not only does yoga help for kind of mind body, but it's also a great exercise as well. So those are the things that we can do throughout the course of our days and our weeks to really help manage our chronic stress. One of the other things I had here to bring was my own personal to-do list. I like to set up my to-do list the night before so that I can put them in categories, Chris, such as urgent, important, and non-urgent. So for me today, urgent was coming here to see you and the viewers today. The thing that may not be so urgent is to see This Is Us, the TV show I like. It can wait. I can kind of record that later. But it's really about trying to categorize your stress each and every day and making sure that you own ways to actually manage it.
Well, I only know enough about meditation to know that it feels great until it's over. But what happens after you've taking that little interval, is there any residue that really continues?
You know, a little bit, Chris, because what you end up having is you get this routine. And so it's almost like you train your brain to know that this particular 15 minutes of your day is only about you. It's only about you unplugging from this world and from this universe and making sure you focus on what is important. The other thing that I couldn't bring with me today that kind of unites all this, one of the best things that we can do for our stress is actually laugh. Laughing is something that we all take for granted, but actually laughter, it really releases endorphins. And endorphins are those wonderful chemicals in our bodies that make us feel good. And that's something we need to do a lot more of, especially in this day and age. We have so many things that are causing stress.
Well, more seriously, we should make sure that if people want to get some more details, you've got something online they can check out?
Absolutely. By all means, my website is drredcross.com. You can also reach me on Facebook, which is Ken Redcross MD.
Thank you very much for being with us.
Thanks for having me.
Dr. Ken Redcross. Up ahead, we'll have sports with Pat Flaherty.